From the moment they are born, a Viking is taught that the gates of Valhalla shall only open to those of legendary deeds. Vikings are taught to be strong. Vikings are taught to be fearless in battle, to spill the blood of their foes, to protect their kin and family, and most importantly, to live for battle. For they know at any moment their deeds can indeed become legendary. Valhalla, they cry. Valhalla and blood. Hello everyone, I am your host, the Conbeastador, and today we will be taking an in-depth look at the man leading any Viking charge, the Warlord. Warlords, a name earned, not given, are those rare individuals that can inspire courage in those around them with their mere presence. Taking positions as anyone from famous jarls to leaders of raiding parties, the Warlords know that their Allfather watches and smiles at their bravery. Whether they are an unbreakable shield or an unstoppable blade, they live to encompass all that their culture is in battle, and I will show you how. If I had to describe the Warlord's playstyle in one word, it would be wild. He loves war, and loves jumping into the fray, just slashing his opponents to pieces, and using a variety of movement and harassment options to leave most opponents completely bewildered and unable to combat him effectively. Not to mention, he has absolutely earned the nickname Throwlord, as he is able to throw opponents around in a greater fashion than any other character in the game. And who better to help us learn about the Warlord than Raiderbot? Say hello to Raiderbot, everyone. He's graciously volunteered his time to be beheaded multiple times for the sake of science. So, renown and revenge mode, we all know about that. So, superior block light attacks. If you've watched my Valkyrie video, then you know about the superior block light attacks. Basically, at the beginning of the animation for light attacks, you have a few frames where if the opponent's blade comes into contact with your shield, you will immediately counterattack. Uninterruptible heavy attacks. Any one of his heavy attacks cannot be interrupted. None of them. Whether they're a jumping attack, whether they're just straight out of a combo, it doesn't matter. If it's got that simple by it, or you're just pressing heavy button, uninterruptible. And full block stance. Basically, by pulling down on the right stick, it goes into all block, which allows you to block attacks from every direction, no matter where. It does have some key differences between the Conqueror's all block, which I will be going into later. Now, as you can see, he actually only has two combos. That's it. Light-heavy, heavy-light. Light-heavy, in my opinion, being the better option simply because it can be done on a counter. So that is the superior light block counter. Right as the opponent's blade is about to come into contact with your shield, press light attack, and that's it. Just to counter the attack immediately and block damage. Now, this is actually, in my opinion, his primary method of blocking damage because, as you're about to see, whenever you do block an attack like that, he actually takes damage through his shield. About 10% of the blow's damage comes through, which can definitely start adding up. After only blocking about 2 stamina bars worth of, attacks, I've lost almost half a bar of health from blocking, so not your best. That was some button mistiming. Let's see if I can go ahead and redeem myself. Huh? There we go, much better. And these can go straight into the combo, the light-heavy combo. So, light-heavy. Perfect. Now, the light-heavy can also be done without doing the counter, of course. However, I found its most effective use to be directly after the counter. It does a fair amount of damage, it's nice. I will say, Raiderbot today, during filming for this, has been very, very aggressive, as you are about to see in a little while. Now, hack and slash for me is not as good a move, simply because starting with a heavy like that feels like it's always gonna trade. Basically, if you are going to use it to trade, then it does allow you to follow up immediately after with a light attack, and does a fair amount of damage. As I've said, that heavy attack is uninterruptible, so on a slow attack, it allows you to really get in 2 wobs of damage instead of 1. I don't find myself using it very often, however. So for this next bit, I really need to emphasize that he has earned his title Throwlord, because even his secondary running attack is a throw. So all you have to do is run at your attack, your attacker, and press X. That's it. That's all that you got. Just run at your attacker, press X. Doesn't knock him to the ground, nothing like that, but by holding the button, you can actually run with him. And allows you to really move him a huge, huge distance, comparable almost to the Conqueror's running attack. I mean, not Conqueror, I apologize, Lawbringer's running attack, which is a massive distance. So definitely great for environmental kills. Head Splitter Leap. Basically, this is his true running attack. It is you running at the opponent and pressing heavy attack. Like that. Now, as you saw his body flash white like that, it is also uninterruptible. So, if your opponent is one hit away from death, it will allow you to get in that last hit and start an execution. So, boom, there you go. Now, let's just try and get one more in. Like that. Wow, double knockout. That is a first on this channel, I think. A Raider bot double knockout. Alright, so, don't really know why I did that, but... the Head Splitter Leap can be done a second time, actually. A second way. All you have to do is dodge forward and press the strong attack. And there, I had the timing done that way, so you could see it is uninterruptible. I did take his attack during the middle of my animation and was able to follow him. That being said, as you can clearly tell, it is never, never a good idea to trade with a raider unless you know that Head Splitter is going to finish him off. I would never recommend trading with him otherwise. In fact, the Warlord doesn't have all of that much health or all of that much armor, and I wouldn't recommend trading except the final blow for a kill in really any scenario. Now, some of the combos in this character seem a tad redundant. This one does not. And I'll get into why they seem redundant later, but all you do is jump forward, and if you successfully hit, press X, and then light attack. That's it. Nice and simple, just X and light attack after that running, leaping strike. So that's something to mix in with other attacks, not really something to be spamming on its own, but can be good for some good damage. Now for Board and Blade, I really need to jump to the bottom of the list and describe the full block stance. Now, he does have a full block stance just like the Conqueror does, but his has a few very great differences. Number one, as you just saw, it takes a ton of stamina, like a huge amount of stamina. Without some equipment differences, you're going to be blocking maybe three hits, so like one, probably two, and then three. Something else I need to show you is that it blocks 100% damage and stops their chains like a normal shield for the Conqueror. Man, I am telling you, Raiderbot has been giving me trouble with this one, with this Warlord tutorial. He has been aggressive. So yeah, it really needs to be noted that his all block blocks 100% and stops his chains, the opposite of the Conqueror. Now this is just the sword and board. Basically what this is just pressing the heavy attack right as they block. You can do it at any time, you don't have to actually block an attack to use it. But all it is right trigger. This is also his only heavy attack that isn't uninterrupted. As you can see, man, his stamina. He has very, very little stamina. Just gonna get some parries to get some stamina back. There we go. Alright, so block and stab. Very, very simple concept. Go into all block, and as soon as their blade makes contact with your shield, simply press RB. Bam. That's it. All there is to it. However, you get maybe two of those without equipment help, which is pretty intense, actually. It really won't be helping you out in any scenario where you aren't in revenge mode. These attacks, such as the RT attack and the any all-block attack, really only help you when you're in revenge mode. That being said, things such as these attacks are fantastic if you are in revenge mode. These two here are what I'm talking about when these combos seem redundant. One of them is simply press X during the middle of a parry animation. The other one is press X during the middle of a parry animation, and then press RB. There I wanted to show you that the timing for this is actually rather precise, and not what you would think it is. You actually have to press X during the parry animation, not afterwards, like the tooltip would have you suggest. So instead of parry comma X, it really should be parry plus X, because you have to do it during the parry animation. So right there, you gotta press X there instead of when it's done. And then the RB right afterwards. Basically, while they're still recoiling, you can just RB in just about any direction and get a little tick of damage off. That's all that combo does. So, button mispress, let's see if I can't get it. Boom, and then that. That's all that there is to it. Nice and easy. Moving on, the headbutt. Now, mastery of this move and interchanging it with your combos is a pretty big deal. It's so fast, it's unblockable, and eats the opponent's stamina. Look at that. You can see with every blow, his stamina dropping. But that is a move that you actually use in between your, in between your combos. So what I was talking about, flowing in between attack modes, like harassment and then attacking and then harassment and then attacking, that's what I'm talking about. It's switching between attacking, dodging, headbutting, things like that. And all you have to do is press forward, you know, dodge forward, and do a headbutt. Press X. Dodge forward, press X. As you can see, it used about half my stamina bar to drain his entire stamina bar. And this is that combo that we did earlier, using that headbutt. Nice and easy. Alright, headbutt repose. Very easy concept. When you are in all block mode, press X. I don't think I showed it long enough that first time, so hold all block mode, press X. It's just the headbutt for all block mode. It doesn't use nearly as much stamina as the attacks do. However, shield block itself requires quite a bit of stamina, so you'll probably only get maybe three of those in. This is another redundant combo. All it is that after the shield block repose, press RB to get additional damage in. That's it. Just fight attack after that. As you can see, stamina management on this character is something I still have yet to get used to. But I don't typically use all block as frequently as I am here. It's really more of an emergency, oh man, I'm getting teamed up button. It's not something to be used all the time. Alrighty, moving on. We have the full block stance back at the bottom. That's actually it. That's all of the character's moves. They can really be collapsed down a little bit because adding RB at the end of everything is a safe option. Now, this might seem like all that there is to the character, but at the beginning of this, I did give him the nickname the Throw Lord. Look at that movement. That is absurd. He can do it out of any guard break in any direction. He is the absolute undisputed master of environmental kills in this game, bar none. There is no enemy in this game that can do environmental kills better than the Warlord can. And here, I don't think I shut it off very well, but he technically hit that tree, which was a wall, and it stunned him, just like the Raiders does. However, as a benefit of not having that hitting you in the face with your knee animation that the Raider does, which is actually a pretty huge boon. I've known a lot of Raiders to take some damage while putting people into that animation. So I'm going to go ahead and try and show a better example of it. However, Raiderbot is being a little bit difficult today, as I've said. So we're going to go ahead and back all the way back up here just to show you how much movement this gets. Not to mention, as far as equipment goes, that run is actually affected by throw distance. You can run even farther with him. I have seen some absurd runs, but there you go. Push him up against the wall, and you get that stun, just like a Raider does. So yeah, really, I've gotten some absurd one kills done to me. I haven't equipped any of those running items, but it has been pretty crazy, some of the kills that I have been part of. We're talking a good 10, maybe 15 yard run kills off cliffs. So I think Raider has shown us enough so far with this Warlord. Let's go ahead and give him the rest he deserves. Thank you very much for your contribution to our knowledge, Raider. Let's get into some multiplayer. Alrighty, let's go ahead and play us some Dominion. Now, in the 50 seconds that they give us, I don't really have enough time to go through each one of these individually and tell you what they do and how they're used, so I'm just going to quickly just cycle through them and show you what he has, and later on I will make a feat-based video where I go through all the feats and what they do in the game and how they're used. However, I will draw attention to the fact that one of those feats was called Auto Revive. That is right, he has apparently the ability to self-resurrect. So I am really looking forward to playing with that a little bit later on. But for now, let's go ahead and get into some Dominion. Now, I will say, I had a blast filming this episode. It was a really nice change of pace from the Conqueror video yesterday. If you watch that, you know I had to vent a little bit on how that was going. But this was just a fun round, and it showed off a lot of what you can do as a Warlord. Also, some multi-person engagements to kind of show you a little bit on how to use the shield. And again, Revenge Warlording is a playstyle that you will come across if you play against Warlords. However, it is pretty equipment-specific. You have to have Revenge gained by defense and Revenge attack, just basically maxed out, just as far as you can push in. And if you can do that, then you can use those all-block attacks during your Revenge mode because you have infinite stamina, like I was showing you. So you can use that Board and Blade, you can use that quick little light attack stab, things like that. And they will do massive damage. So we go ahead and get into this fight. We're a little bit behind, a little bit of a disadvantage, but you know what? That is A-okay. I always like a challenge. So, whoop, networking issues, but it looks like we're gonna be okay. My heart always stops at that moment, right when you enter a match like that, and it looks like this might be the end, just right off the bat. But no, and I'm happy it wasn't. So this map is actually the Warlord's Playground. We love these maps the Warlords do because of things like this. Just Shigoki, there's a cliff, just so simple. He is the throw lord. Vikings love to throw. And it makes nothing makes the Warlord happier than a good throw kill. So basically for him, like I said, his playstyle is he loves war. He just jumps right into it. You see a point, man, you just go for it. Doesn't matter how many people are in there. Doesn't matter what's going on in there. You are war crazy. You are looking to gain entry into Valhalla. So go ahead and die honorably in combat. So we have point A up here. There's a little faster Orochi. He doesn't know what he's getting himself into. I tried to get that throw right there, but it's not going to work. However, there we go. Throw Lord. As simple as that. See, his ability to control opponent's movements in the cardinal directions mean if there is a cliff within 20 meters of an opponent, they better be really afraid of taking on this Warlord. This is actually really, I didn't know these two were coming, so I'm like, well, let's just get back up here. Now, the Lawbringer knows what's up. He goes the other way, but this Orochi didn't learn the lesson. So here we go with this Warlord, Lawbringer, and I'm gonna prove to you that not all kills by the Warlord are throw kills. Here we have a perfect example of just mercilessly beating this Lawbringer to death. Just be so sporadic and just be war crazy. Just be this crazy attacker that just will not let up on your opponent. Either that or be the perfect defender. In the opener for him, I really did call him either an unstoppable blade or an unbreakable shield. He is one or the either at any given time. I will say here, Shigoki are very, very hard counters to these Warlords because they cannot be thrown around and they have that hyper armor. So we have two guys here right now. I'm trying to get at least one of them to get into this bear trap right there so I can throw. However, that is just not going to be how it's going to go today. I go for the Shigoki for a throw, however, I miss the throw, just timing-wise. And I end up eating that whole Shigoki heavy attack. Now, if you watched my video on the Shigoki, you know these guys hit like a truck. They hit insanely hard, and I didn't even see him charging up that attack. So, I stood very, very little chance of surviving a bullet like that, even through revenge mode. But this is not the end. Valhalla must wait for us because we've got more work to do. If you see a point contested, that means there are enemies there. Let's go. I see my buddy is over here. He's in trouble fighting off someone, so let's go ahead and go help. That is the idea behind him. I can't stress that enough. Just be a warlord. Be a lord of war. Constantly be aggressing the opponent or holding multiple opponents at bay. So, yeah, obviously, our teammate did very well there, so we're going to come on back over here. I also see that our troops aren't doing so well at B here. They're starting to get overwhelmed. Eventually, B will go back to neutral if left to its own devices for a while. So me and my buddy here, we start to clear B out. But the Shigoki is going to get back in our face. The thing about Shigoki is he has a very, very hard window to figure out when it comes to the superior block light attack. I have almost no practice against Shigoki in that regard, and because of that, it can be a little bit difficult to get those superior block light attacks in, which is what I was trying to do. Basically, like I said, you take about 10% of the damage through your block, and 10% of a Shigoki hit is a fair bit of damage. So I got greedy. I tried to walk away with everything. I came back with nothing.
So if you can't get the timing down on hard enemies like that, just, you know, take that 10%. Really, just block the attack. Do what you can. Don't make that mistake like I did. So we're going to go back to our little playground up here, A. It's been fantastic. But fantastic for us so far. Why change it? And this little bear trap here, it's one of his starting feats, and we're going to learn a pretty valuable lesson about this bear trap, something I didn't know until we played this game. Obviously, the Warlord excels at holding points that have ledges. Being able to just one-on-one some opponents is fantastic in these kinds of areas. So I'm like, good, I'm going to throw this Shigoki. It turns out that when that bear trap activates, it takes everyone with it. Now, I am going to try and throw this Shigoki around. It's just, it's not working out very well. Not able to get my throws and go in the directions I want, and then a teammate shows up. I'm like, oh, well, this isn't good anymore. That was a great example of the all-block usage. So now we're just going to sit here. We've got to play really defensive. Really keep that stamina low on that Shigoki. Things aren't looking very good for us, so let's just go and hold up here. Activate this, and now you have infinite stamina. However, now it's a triple team. I call out for help, and all I can hope to do is hold. So I just go into all block. It's well working well for a little bit, but this Nobuyoshi knows how to deal with it. She guard blocks me, and that's the end of the Warlord. But that's a little bit of how to use it. I have absolutely no equipment helping me out about how to, you know, increase my damage using the execution, getting execution faster. Sorry, not execution, revenge mode. I should say revenge mode. Getting revenge mode faster, things like that, there is equipment that helps out with that greatly. So if you want to run a revenge Warlord, then you really need to go for that equipment. Otherwise, just hold out for your teammates to come and help you. I see this big old brawl over here, and I'm like, this is exactly where the Warlord belongs. He's going to be chasing down opponents, using that jump attack, that huge distance, catching opponents in the back. Don't let him escape. Just get in there and throw down. The Shigoki looks like he needs to go down next. Be really unpredictable about how you're attacking people. And check that out. Another kill. That's what the Warlord is all about. Jumping into combat almost recklessly. Always, you know, figure out who you can take on, but make sure that you're always in someone's face. And finally, last but not least, we have this Lawbringer. So let's just go ahead and throw him around, really just get him off balance. If you see your opponent has a combat advantage, take it from him with your ability to move him around. And of course, when the timing's right, finish them off. Boom. Third kill, three of the four executions to end the round belong to the Warlord. That was a fantastic round and honestly an absolute blast to play. Thank you guys so much for joining me on this. I really appreciate it. Thank you for watching the video. Join me on Twitter. I have video updates and polls on it all the time. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a thumbs up to help support the video and the channel. I'd really appreciate it. And of course, if you really want to show your support, do not forget to subscribe. Thank you all again so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.